If you are too lazy like me to stand up and press the power button on a computer at your home, or you want to save some time and energy, keep watching as we are going to wake some devices from Home Assistant dashboard entirely remotely with a push of a virtual button. There is a so-called Wake On LAN function that allows you to send one magic packet over your local network towards a specific device and to wake it up if it is in a sleep or shutdown mode. This method can be also added in home automations, and the best part is that most of the devices that you and I have already support this Wake On LAN functionality. Before we begin, I want to share that I've made a PDF to go with this video and you can download it for free. I go into much more details there and I've created some interactive activities so you can practice what you have learned and memorize it for life. If you would like to download the PDF, all you have to do is click the link in the description box or follow this link, or you can scan that QR code. Then you enter your name and your email address, you sign up for my mailing list, and the PDF will be downloaded in your computer. After that, you've joined my free PDF club. You automatically receive my weekly articles, news, updates, and offers. It's a free service and you can unsubscribe at any time with just one click. Now, let's go straight into today's topic, waking up devices remotely with Home Assistant. First, you have to check that your device that you want to wake support Wake On LAN, or WOL for short. As I said in the beginning, most modern and not so modern devices that are produced in the last 10 or 50 years have that Wake On LAN support, but you have to double check that. This can be done in multiple ways. For example, you can contact the support of your device and ask them, "Hey, is this device support Wake On LAN?" Or you can check your device manual, or if you have a custom built computer, you have to check your motherboard's manual or your network card manual. You can search online and so on and so forth. Second, you may have Wake On LAN support, but it can be disabled by default and you just have to enable it before start using it. Most of the times you have to enter in the BIOS of your device. Usually this can happen by hitting the Del key or F12 or F1 keys or something similar immediately after you power on your device. Once you got inside your BIOS, all you have to do is to find that Wake On LAN option and just enable it. Unfortunately, every motherboard vendor is having different place and even different wording for that Wake On LAN feature. And again, you have to search for it a bit. There is no universal solution that I can show you right now. So, the two main things until now. First, you have to check that your device of interest, the one that you want to wake up, is supporting Wake On LAN feature. And second, you have to enable that feature if it is disabled. And usually this can happen from your device BIOS. The third and final thing that is needed before we go into the fun part is the MAC address of your device. Let me explain. You have a device that you want to wake remotely. This device is having a network card. This network card has a unique physical address, or so-called MAC address, that looks something like this, and you need to get that address to continue. This can happen by going to your network settings or by entering in your router web interface and to search for your device of interest there. It doesn't matter which way you choose to get it. As a result, you need that MAC address saved somewhere in your notes, as we are going to use it later. As summary, you need a device that supports Wake On LAN. This Wake On LAN feature should be enabled and you have to get the MAC address or physical address of your device network card. That is all. Once you have all these three things, you can proceed further. Let me know in the comments what your device is and is it supporting Wake On LAN feature. Or maybe you can ask there and someone with enough free time will check it for you. And that, my friend, so far was the hardest part, checking some things and gathering others. Now, the Home Assistant party can begin. Fortunately, adding devices in Home Assistant for remote waking up is very easy and fast, as you will see in a few seconds. But before that, let me ask you a few very simple questions. Do you know what Home Assistant is? Do you have a Home Assistant working already? Do you know how to install Home Assistant at your home easy, fast and free? If you answer no on some of these questions, then you may wish to attend my free Home Assistant webinar. I'll talk there about the different installation methods of Home Assistant, their pros and cons, as well as one super simple method to run Home Assistant on a PC in under 5 minutes. And that is perfect for testing the Wake On LAN functionality. To reserve your seat to my webinar, which is absolutely free, just scan that QR code with your camera's phone or follow the link in the video description. Now, to add a Wake On LAN button inside Home Assistant that once pressed will wake your device, follow these steps. This is my test Home Assistant where I'll add the Wake On LAN buttons here to wake my devices. I'll press the C button here and I'll type integrations. Then I'll select navigate integrations, add integration, and I'll search for Wake On LAN. Here it is. And now I have to add my MAC address of the device that I want to wake up. This is my MAC address. Broadcast address is usually this one. I just type it and the broadcast port is usually 9. And I'm ready. I'll hit on submit button and that's it. I'm ready. I can add it in an area, but I'll just click on finish. And if I go somewhere here, I'll see this Wake On LAN device. I can click on it and I can rename it. This is my network attached storage, so I'll rename it to NAS and I'll click on update. And I have this button now that if I press, this will wake up my NAS device. Let's test this. I'll grab my phone, I'll start the camera. So this is my NAS computer and this is my Home Assistant. Currently the NAS is switched off and I'll just press on this button right here. I'll increase the brightness a bit. Where is my mouse? Here it is. I'll click on the press button and immediately the NAS is turned on. You can see the LEDs are blinking. Great. I can go back and I can add one more device if I wish to. I'll search again for Wake On LAN and I'll paste another MAC address. This is the MAC address of my Zima board. It is a mini PC. And again, the broadcast address is this one and the broadcast port is 9. Submit. Finish. And now I have two Wake On LAN devices. Again, I can rename this one. For example, mini PC update. And now I can add this to my dashboard. Next, add to dashboard. And I also want to add the NAS button to my dashboard. And now if I go here, I can see both of these cards. They are not very beautiful, but I can edit them and I can rename them here as well. Mini PC and NAS. That's better. Now I have two buttons. Of course, I can make it to look like this, or I can use style cards. I can do whatever I want, but this is just for the demo. You can customize it as you wish. Now let's test this mini PC. I have to open it and I have to shut it down because currently it is working. I have Home Assistant supervised installed on this device and I have to shut down the whole system. From here, shut down. I'll again turn on my phone. I'll grab my computer and see you. Okay, this is my mini PC. It is currently shut down. As you can see, the network cable is not blinking. The LED here is not blinking as well. So if I click on this mini PC button right here in my Home Assistant, the computer starts immediately. It is waken up by Home Assistant and the LAN port is blinking. It was that simple to wire a device that can be waked up remotely from Home Assistant. Let me know in the comments below, did you manage to wake your devices like that? Typing simple yes or no is absolutely fine, because I don't know for what are you talking about. Now, if you have a Windows PC that you also want to shut down remotely using Home Assistant, go and watch that video of mine. I'm showing there exactly that. Thanks for waking up some devices with me. I'm Kirill and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!